Hi all, Aditya here from JH Softech. In this session, we are going to discuss the project number 40. We'll be creating a infoset, making use of a DSO and master data attributes. So this is the only way in which we can get the master data into a report program, a report. Okay, so let's create this. And for this, we'll go for the JH5_info_area. Okay, so we have this. Right click on this, insert. Okay, info objects. Let's go to the info objects. Right click on this info object category, info in object catalog for characteristics. JH6_IOC. Cats create activate. Right click on this info object catalog, change to key figures. Now JH6IOK key figures, say okay, create activate. Now right click on this characters info object catalog. In this we have JH6_customer_number. Let's make it as 10, activate this. And for this customer number only, we also want to maintain the attributes. So let's maintain the attributes here. For this, what are the attributes that we want to maintain is? We want to maintain CID, customer ID, and location and phone number. So we have to go for JH6_CID. Create as a character, customer ID, say okay, just say character 10, say okay, activate. Okay, so now let us finish off all, CJ6_, what else we have here, location, LOC. Location. And then we have one more is phone number. So JH6_phone key figure number. We just have to change that again. Say okay, activate dependent objects, yes. So we are building the attributes here itself now only. And then for the DSO, for building the DSO, we need customer name, material purchased, quantity, amount, all these things also have to be, you know, built here. So this customer number and location are being displayed outside because maybe this is not ticked. Like, you know, when you click this, you can see this here, attributes only. If it is not clicked, sometimes it will be displayed. Anyways, like, this is fine for us. Now here what we'll do is right click on this characteristic info object, and then we go for JH6 customer name. In this, we have to go for character. Customer name is 20. Activate. Material purchased. Also quantity and amount. Okay, quantity and amount will create in key figures. Quantity JH6 quantity. Fixed, no, do we have fixed? No, we have variable, right? Okay, we'll have unit, so 0 unit, activate. Then we are going to have another key figure called JH6 amount. Then when we have to go for 0 unit, activate. Oh, sorry, 0 currency, activate. Now once it's been done, we have to go to the info provider, and in the info provider we need to call those two things. Like, you know, we need to first create the data store object here, JH6 underscore DSO. Okay, now here, okay, so here we just have to drag and drop those things, characteristics. In DSO, we just have to have customer number, customer name, material purchased. So customer ID isn't there here, so we should not drag here. Customer number, customer name, location data fields, material purchase data fields, and location, material purchase, customer number, customer ID shouldn't be here. Location also wasn't there here. It was not there in the, you know, this one isn't there. So customer number, purchase, material number is what we have to drag and drop, but location we'll delete it. And okay, go for key figures. In the key figures, we'll drag and drop this in the data fields by default. Activate. So once it's activated, we just have to again right click on this, insert characteristic as info provider, and what is the characteristic that we have? JH6 customer number. This is the one for which we have maintained the master data. So let's go to the data source now. Right click on this, create application component. What we have is JH6 underscore AC. Now we just have to right click on this, create data source, and this data source is for what? JH6 underscore transaction data, say okay, and this extraction we just have to pass to the drive place, my documents. What was the name which we had? JHSoftTech DSO. Open. First row should be ignored. Comma delimited. Just say comma. Proposals load example. Always allow. Okay. Just say okay. Oh, file is open. Close the file. Now load example. Fields. Preview. Read preview data, activate. Once we see the data, let's create the info package and load the data into it. So right click on this, create info package, and this we have JH6 underscore IP1, and then we have to go for schedule, start, then monitoring, and in this we have the records. Since it's green, I'm not checking the data inside it, so it's by default it will be loaded. Create data source, and I'll create another data source, JH6 underscore ATT attributes, and in this I have to select as master data attributes here, because we are loading master data attributes, and then go for extraction. In the extraction we need to go for what we have is JHSoftTech master data attributes, open, first row should be ignored, comma separated value, comma, proposal load example, always allow, okay, fields, preview, read preview data, activate. Okay, there's overflow items, let's fix it up. J it's of tech attributes, and this, let's reduce this. We need to fix it up in a different way actually for that. So anyways, like, save. Now here, this is the data. Now let's create a info package here. J6_IP2. Say okay, schedule, start. Once this is done, monitor, this is successfully loaded. I'm not checking the data. It will be loaded actually. Info provider. In the info provider, right click on this DSO, create transformations, and the source is data source. J6*F4, enter, and this is DSO because we are loading the data into the DSO. Now just say okay, master data attributes, map this customer number to customer number, customer name to customer name, material purchased to material purchased, quantity to quantity, amount to amount, and save and activate. Zero record mode by default will get created here. And once it's activated, you have to create the DTP, data transfer process. So here, right click on this, create DTP, just say okay, here full upload, execute, activate, click on execute, yes. Now monitor, this is the contents, field selection, okay, activate. We have to activate the data because this is a DSO, right? Yes, select this, activate, start. We first need to activate the data in the data source, DSO. Okay. It will take couple of seconds. Okay, let's load the data into the master data attributes now. So for loading the master data into master data attributes, right click on this, create transformations, and here we have to go for data source, J6*F4, enter, this is the attributes, say okay, then we'll map customer number to customer number, CID to CID, LOC to LIC, phone number to phone number, activate. You all following, right? Yeah. Okay, so here, then what we have to do is we have to go ahead with the DTP, right click on this, create DTP, and say okay, and extraction, full upload, go to the execute, activate, execute, yes. Okay, this is successfully loaded. We can check the data here, contents. We will have this data here. Okay, parallelly we'll also have the data in the DSO as well. We have this data successfully loaded here. Now let's go ahead and check the data in the DSO as well. Right click on the DSO, display data, field selection for output, select all, execute, execute. And this is the data successfully loaded here as well. Now what we'll do is we will join these two and create an info set. For that, right click on this JH5 and create info set. And in the info set, I'll create it as JH6_IS. JHS IS. Say okay. Okay. No. Sorry. So right click on this, create info set, JH6_IS, JH6, say IS1. And now here, DSO. What is the DSO that we have here? JH6*F4. That is one. Info object. What is the info object that we have? JH6*. And